This is the local show and the glorified rehearsal. And right now we got Gunther's Radio here in the lovely Checkerboard Lounge. So why don't you guys jump into it?
I'm
yourselves. And to state the name of the songs that you just played.
Hi, everybody. I'm John Farrell. The first song we played was Bring Me Back, and that last one you just heard is called The Time Has Come.
Hi, I'm Parker, and I play bass for the band.
Okay, thanks for that, Parker. I'm Jeff. Jeff Nicholson. I play drums for the band.
All right. So, what place to better start than the beginning? How did you guys begin as a band?
I'll take this one. Right. It actually started. Me and Parker started jamming. We were kind of a bass drums duo thing, which you don't get a lot of anymore nowadays.
Yeah.
And we wrote a lot of jams together, and then we were like, this is so boring. Like, we need some guitar. Like,
yeah.
We need something to spice us up. So, John is actually my cousin, so we hit him up, and we just started playing together, and we all started writing songs. It was really cool.
That's wholesome. Sorry. Like I said, this is my first time. Like,
hey, same here.
Yeah. I don't know. How would you describe your sound? It has a certain sound to us, but we don't ever want to mislabel here.
Oh, God.
How do you guys define your music?
I don't even know. I mean, we're like a mix between all of our favorite bands and then, like, all of our influences. And just kind of everything that we take it in, and mash it together. I don't know.
Yeah. All right. I was going to save that for after the next one. I know. Like I said. Why don't we just ask it now, I guess. What influences do you guys?
I think I've got this down. For Jeff, he's more into the punk stuff, so Green Day and Nirvana is kind of what he likes. For John, he's definitely into the blues. That seems to be...
Influences are Beatles and
Beatles
all
and
that
Blue.
Old stuff, and then
you can hear it on that last track.
Yeah.
Foo Fighters too. And for me, just playing bass, like the funky stuff. So, Chili Peppers is my main go-to.
All right. Do you guys want to jump into another couple of songs?
Yeah,
then,
of course.
Because I got, and then I'll ask some more.
Yeah,
sounds great.
Awesome. This next one's called Differences.
Can't you be more than should ask this one first. What was it like? How long have you guys been doing?
Playing together?
Yeah.
I think we've been playing with each other a little over 2 years.
A little over two
yeah.
years? All right. So where was your first place that you ever played together, and what was that feeling like?
The first place we ever played together was actually at a church picnic.
Really?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
It was raining, so it was moved indoors into a gymnasium.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was good.
It told us to quiet down a lot.
And we didn't.
We played even louder.
We played that song, too. That was the first. Was that the first original we played?
Yeah, that's one of the jams that they were playing. And I started playing along with them, and I was like, guys, I wrote this song, like, 5 years ago. Like, I have lyrics to this song. And we just started playing it, and that was the first original.
Nice.
Good stuff.
Yeah. All right. Well, here's another question for each of you. What would you say your favorite artist would be, and what would your favorite album be?
I'll start. Green Day is, like, my favorite band. I know it's very typical, but I really don't care.
It's what you like.
Yeah, it's what I like. The album Dookie by Green Day is kind of like the, I guess, soundtrack to my, like, whole high school, like, career. It's just, I've listened to it at least, like, 300 times. Like, I just love that album.
All right.
I don't even know if I have a favorite artist. I just, you know, I mean, I like the Foo Fighters. I think they're, you know, they're my favorite band, and then favorite album. Too many of them.
Yeah.
Too many.
Don't swear on the radio, by the way.
I said she.
All right.
Yep.
I'm just,
please don't. Also, because of our licensing, you guys, like, because I'll ask you probably about shows later. You can't say prices. All
right.
That has to do with our FCC licensing.
That's fine.
Favorite.
Jeff's gonna know the answer to this, but for what I'm doing in this band, well, my only band, I'm not gonna sound like I play in more than one. But my favorite album is Blood Sugar Sex Magik by the Chili Peppers.
Really?
Yeah, that was such a big album for me. I became completely obsessed with it, and I learned every song on that album like by ear on bass. So that's it's definitely my favorite.
Hold on a second.
We're good. We're ready. We got tons more original.
Yeah, I am sure you guys do. I don't want to just, like, go through quicker questions. I'm just also trying not to have dead air.
I understand.
Yeah.
What's the deal with airplane food?
Airline food.
So, yeah. I'm not asking that one yet. I had a good joke for that one. I can still do the other one.
Stop.
All right. Actually, do you guys supposed to want to go on to another one? I'm sorry.
We can do a couple more. Yeah.
Like I said, I'm trying not to just have it be like two quick questions.
You know, man, it's all good. You got songs, you got questions.
Yeah.
Let's go. All right, this next one's called Let Me Go.
I don't know what to say. You know we knew it was on the way. I don't know what to do. I'm
you guys played any local venues? What's your favorite?
The most local venue I can think of is the Hamburg Palace. In it's in Hamburg. It's a movie theater. Mm-hmm. It's a cool place. Like, it fits a lot of people. That's my favorite place that I think we've played. Mm-hmm. But we have yet to try to get out there more, play a lot more shows, which is cool.
Like I said, we're strong and small. So what is your ultimate goal as Gunther Radio?
Gunther's Radio.
Huh? Yeah.
Someone else take this.
I mean, just to play music, get our name out there and see what happens,
Basically, John said it correct. Just try and play as much music and have our music touch as many people as you possibly can. That's the ultimate goal.
Yeah.
I mean, success is nice, but
it's all about the music. It's really what it comes down to.
It seriously is.
Yeah.
Seeing people's reactions to our songs is like the greatest thing for me.
Yeah.
Seeing them like truly enjoy it, that's the greatest thing.
Yeah. So if you guys get successfully, what would your ideal tour be like?
Anywhere and everywhere.
In the United States.
Anywhere and everywhere.
All right.
That's it.
Preferably to crowds over 10,000. That'd be ideal.
I'm looking for at least 20,000 people.
That might be too much to ask.
Yeah, we'll see if that happens. But
yeah. So, are there any, what do you think of the Buffalo music scene as a whole?
I think it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean,
it's pretty heavy.
It's heavy.
A lot of punk.
We're not really heavy. We're alternative, I guess. Is the best.
Yeah, I mean,
some heaviness.
Yeah.
Like I said, like, it's just kind of everything that we've ever listened to in our lives and then just mashed it together.
But there's a lot of cool bands in Buffalo, and, like, there's a lot of originality and, like, opportunities for people to play, which is cool.
Is there any favorite bands that you enjoy playing with?
I see you got the Scarecrow show sticker up here.
Yes, they did. They won battle a few years, was it 2 years ago, I believe?
Yeah, they're bass players, basically.
Functional Flow is a good band.
Yeah,
they're great. Actually, my older brother had a high school band a few years back, and if I'm correct, I'm pretty sure they got to play a show with Functional Flow, which is awesome because they're one of the bigger local bands, right?
I believe I'm not personally from Buffalo, so
I'm non-local.
A refugee.
I mean, I've come here and I've met, like, doing this show, I've met so many great local bands. So, like, it's just about getting out there because, I live in a small town where there's, like, maybe three bands.
Yeah.
So, like,
what was
local bands, and they're all, they're, like, all heavy metal, which, I mean, isn't bad because that's what I happen to like, but
yeah.
I don't, at the same time, I like diversity.
Yeah.
That variety is, they'll get you.
So, yeah, when you're in a class, you don't really get that when you're in a small class of, like, maybe 300 kids.
Yeah.
Do you think that's small? My class, my senior class is 45 kids.
I mean, yeah.
That's a challenge.
But, I mean, my school is also, like, 7 towns.
There you go.
So, yeah, like, the actual town itself is maybe, like, if we had, like, the actual town itself, there would have been, like, maybe about, like, 50 to 100.
Yeah.
It's, like I said, it's just so, like, we just cover a lot of area. That's why we have that.
Yeah.
So,
this next song, I'm probably going to mess up, but
this is one of our favorites. This one's called Migraine. Yeah.
It's a Tom song.
What's that song about, John?
That song is about
a girl.
Yeah.
That's inspiration for me.
I mean, yeah. Seems to be the only things I can write about sometimes.
All right. So here at WBNY, we like to ask our guests the controversial questions. So this is a very serious question. the most serious question I'm going to ask of the night.
I'm scared now.
What do you guys think of garlic bread?
Garlic bread?
Oh my god,
it's delicious.
If you don't like garlic bread, you shouldn't be alive. I'm kidding. That's terrible.
Like, fall down to the earth. garlic bread.
Garlic bread is great.
I wake up in the morning and I piss excellence. And garlic bread is the reason for that.
Dude, you could drop a piece of garlic bread on the floor, and I would eat it off the floor.
Perfect, that's nasty.
Off the floor of the bathroom at my public.
All right, this has gone too far.
Hey, I mean, every Italian man gets together a
question,
Chad.
You know what? I mean, if you don't have a little Italian in you, I mean, I don't know what you are then.
I hope that was a good enough answer.
I just want to tell the audience, our listeners, equipment you use?
Oh. I'm using Parker's sister's drum set because I'm poor and I don't have one. That's not entirely true, but.
Go ahead, Parker.
All right. I'm pretty basic. I've got a Sterling Music Man bass. I've got a Super Overdrive pedal and envelope filter, and then I've got a Fender Rumble 200 bass. And that's pretty much it. All the essentials.
Yeah, I have a Epiphone Les Paul. It's my absolute favorite guitar, and I will never part with it.
So pretty.
And a V22 Bagheera amp. It's brand new. It's a tube. It's pretty beefy.
By the way, for everyone listening, John is playing with a broken guitar string right now.
Okay, listen. For those of you who are like, oh, come on, man. They were brand new when I put them on.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, when I put them on, they're brand new strings. So, like,
you
spread
it too hard, man.
Broke.
You broke the string.
And the fact that we can't hear a single difference shows how good of a guitar player you are.
We love you, John.
Thanks.
Round of applause at home for Gunther.
I'm clapping and I'm inside.
Is that not allowed?
Huh?
Really? What? You can? Oh.
Yay! Woo!
I'm speechless.
All right. So, since there's three of you, hypothetically speaking, let's say you got a hold of the genie's lamp from Aladdin. Got to wish for, like, your ideal, like, drum set and guitars, what would they be?
Oh, my Lord.
I would get a guitar. I know I'm the drummer, but I also love the guitar.
I would get probably a 57 Gibson Les Paul, just because, like,
I think I'd get a Rickenbacker bass.
Oh!
Yeah. John's got one, but he'll never let me play it ever because I break everything.
I'd probably go for like a vintage, like, Gibson Explorer because I just love that.
Oh, yeah.
Aren't you getting that, though?
I'm going to get an Epiphone because.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And for those of you who are like, oh, Epiphone sucks, you know what? Who cares? It's a guitar, and it plays the same.
Meaty
beefy tones, Steve.
So I guess I'll ask this now. Do you guys have any upcoming shows that you want to promote? Like I said, just get safe prices.
We actually do. We have a show May 14th at the Mohawk Place in the city of Buffalo. It's a sweet venue.
It is.
I'm not really positive on the time yet, but if you want to stay updated on our shows, go follow us on Instagram. Gunthersradio.official. So, yeah, you'll find us on there.
It's spelled exactly like it sounds.
Yeah.
Gunther's Radio.
People put in, like, .dot. It's a punctuation mark.
It's a period.
It's a period. Yeah.
It's that time of the month.
What about the June show in the Village for the garden opening at UBES?
Yeah, exactly. Again, we don't have an exact date, but if you follow
it's in early June, and we'll probably post about it soon.
Yeah,
we'll let you guys know. Just follow the account, and you'll know everything.
We advertise.
We need
Where I'm not just to, like, become successful.
yeah, just be annoying about everything you're doing.
Yeah. Of course, just spam everybody's DMs.
I personally message everyone.
Jeff walked into a class today, told the entire class to follow up.
And we got 13 followers. So.
Yeah.
Woohoo! So, I'm just looking at, do you want to describe your tattoo there?
Which one?
I mean,
on the forearm?
Yeah.
I drew this up. It's a guitar pick with the headstock coming up through it, and then my initials right above it. Yeah.
I don't know. Do you want to talk about your other ones?
The other one is just it's just a familia tattoo with the Italian flag, because, you know, I'm about family, you know. I am in a Italian family, and we have 17 children.
Yeah, that's insane.
And I'm number 8.
Really?
I'm right in the middle. Right in the middle of it all.
John's still kind of normal.
Hey, you know what? I'm not.
I think by child 8, you have it correctly done as parenting. Like,
Hell yeah. Shout out to my parents.
First child's you probably is not going to turn out the best, you know. But by the second or third, you probably got it down. I don't know. I'm the oldest.
For my siblings who are listening, I love you guys.
It's the most fun, fun thing in the world, going over there and practicing. It is, and it's awesome. And it's so much fun being there. And they're all super musical, so.
By the way, shout out to all my friends. I hope you guys are listening. I love you all.
What friends?
They're imaginary.
Thanks, guys. I don't know who's listening, but.
Yeah, anyone who's tuning in, thanks so much.
Yo, blow up my phone if you're listening, by the way.
We got,
how many?
We actually only have 2 more songs left.
All right.
I mean, you can also go further and play covers, but I mean.
Yeah, you're more than allowed to. And hold on. Let me just do the quick legal ID.
Yeah.
And you are listening to 91.3 FM WBNY, Buffalo's original alternative since 1982, brought to you by the Buffalo State Student Activity Fee. And WBNY is operating under safe harbor hours, so viewer discretion is advised. So, guys, if you want to play a song, it only applies to front door. Like I said, it only applies for songs.
Oh, okay, because I actually.
Like I said, it only applies for songs. So, like, not while speaking.
Alright, we're gonna carry on.
You wanna go on to your next song?
Yeah, this next one is called How Long. I wrote this song with a buddy of mine, Chris Weber. I don't know if he's listening, but
I love you, Chris.
Yeah, shout out to him. It's called How Long. Thank you.
Radio. Again, follow us on Instagram at Gunther's Radio, period. Official.
Is there any other social media you wish to promote?
I'm trying to get it together, Facebook, but like, not old.
Facebook coming soon.
Facebook coming soon. All right.
Thank you.
encore for a song that we totally forgot.
All right. I told the people in the studio that that was your last song. So
yeah, sorry, that was my bad.
In the studio.
I love you guys so much. Done. Thank you for dealing with our.
Can you give me an E, please?
Give me an E.
Why don't you inform the people what song this is?
Oh, this song is called Stay With Me. And the only reason it's last is because we completely forgot to play it.
And you know, sometimes you just, when your adrenaline's kicked in, you just forget things. And that's just what happened. Alright, this is Stay With Me.
So hard.